Hi, Herman Williams here. I get a lot of questions about a couple of videos I did about grip and lag and casting, and I wanted to specifically address a few of those for you. I guess ultimately what people are really asking is how to get more power in a golf swing. And I have videos that I've done that cover the grip and they cover lag and they cover casting, but I want to highlight some things, maybe do a video series here actually about how to get more lag, how to avoid casting, and how to get more power. So let's start talking about the hands and the grip and the wrist action that's going to generate more lag for you. So first thing I want to show you, in my grip video originally I talked to you about a fairly neutral grip. That was in an effort to help you then move into a flat wrist at the top of the backswing, followed by an active release of the hands. Now honestly, most of that information is designed to help you hit the golf ball straighter. It wouldn't necessarily increase your lag, it wouldn't necessarily increase your power, but it would give you a fairly consistent ball striking with straight results, and that's obviously a very important thing when it comes to playing golf. But I get a lot of questions about how to get more lag and how to get more distance, so I want to talk to you about some things you can modify a little bit to do that. First would be, assuming you're a right-handed golfer, with left-hand grip, make that grip a little bit stronger. In other words, we would move it a little bit to the right. You'll remember maybe if you saw my grip video, got the little short club that we used in that video. We talked about putting the left thumb at 12 o'clock, which would be right on the middle of the grip. But for more lag and more power, we might move that to a stronger position, which starts to move the thumb over more towards what we defined as 1 o'clock on the handle. We could even go maybe a little beyond that. It definitely gets this V moving towards the right shoulder, which is in all the classical descriptions of grip. And it gets at least two knuckles showing over here. Maybe even the third knuckle would come into view. I have actually a picture of the grip that I'll show you real quick, so I'll jump over here to the computer and just show you that real fast. So here's my own grip, which I consider reasonably neutral, but the things you'll note here, the right hand, this V is very centered. V of the left hand is angled more off to the right, towards the right shoulder. And of course you can see the two knuckles right here, and that grip could potentially be stronger if we're really searching for the most lag and the most power. Okay, so we'll come back here. That's left hand. Make it stronger than possibly what you interpreted from my first video on grip. Now, that gives this left wrist more opportunity to hinge. At that particular angle, it can get a little bit cupped, which I'm sure you're thinking, uh-oh, that violates my other video about flat wrist, but you've got to match your grip and your wrist position together. So if you go stronger left hand, then you can go into a more cupped wrist. Bottom line is that wrist position with that grip position, it will hinge more, provided you know what to do with it. Now, right hand grip plays a role in this. We still need the right hand grip to be fairly neutral to weak, and that's because the right wrist can bend back further. This is dorsiflexion. It can bend in that direction farther than it can bend in this direction. By using a slightly strong left, weak right, we can get the maximum amount of wrist bend or wrist hinge in the top of the backswing. You'll get mostly dorsiflexion out of the right wrist and this upward hinging here, sort of into the snuff box of the left wrist. But slightly cupped will be okay here if our goal is more lag, more distance, and avoiding the casting. All right, so we'll assume you have stage one. You've got the strong left hand, weak to neutral right hand. Now, part two, going into the backswing, how do you get more hinge? The sensation you want to have is pushing the butt of the handle away from your chest. You literally want to lever it right there. If I split my grip apart and hold it with these two fingers, it's as though I'm levering the two hands against one another, particularly the left hand pushing the butt end away from me. That will get the maximum amount of hinge here. Now you'll also notice looking in the camera here that my right elbow is below my left arm. It's very important for the right arm to fold down. It doesn't have to be right against the body, but it must fold down. If you have a high or flying right elbow, it'll just push the wrist back out and not allow them to hinge. Okay, so those are kind of three big critical details to help you get more lag in your backswing. I'll do it now with a 7-iron. I'll just step back further into the studio here. So strong left hand, got the thumb at least at 1 o'clock, maybe in a little farther to the right, V coming to the right shoulder, 2 to 2.5 knuckles showing. I'll place the right hand now. It's going to cover the left thumb somewhat on top of the club. Got a really pronounced trigger finger here on the side of the golf club. I'll start the takeaway, fairly normal takeaway at the start, just a one-piece move here. And then as I reach around the waist-high area, I'll really begin to push the handle away from my body, really firming out the left arm, creating a lot of width right here. And of course, the low right elbow, which helps, again, achieve more wrist bend in the right wrist for the lag. Now that takes care of the hands, arms, and elbows to generate the most lag and wrist hinge at the top of your backswing. And we'll come back with some more videos to talk about how to preserve that angle and how to use it in the downswing. So I hope that helps you for now. Get out and start to try those tips. A little bit different grip. Definitely create the width and the hinge in the backswing. Keep that trailing arm down. And that should get you more lag to start with, and we'll come back with some more videos to help you finish that off. Till next time, I'm Herman Williams, and you've just been Hermanized.